What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, undefeated, unified WBC, IBF, welterweight, world champion, superstar boxer who is widely considered to be top 3 pound for pound best fighters in the world, Earl the True Spence Jr. He will be taking on legendary 8-division world champion, iconic Filipino superstar boxer, Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao, in what looks like it's going to be a unification bout, where Manny Pacquiao, after he defeated then undefeated unified WBC, WBA, welterweight, world champion, superstar boxer Keith One Time Thurman for only his WBA title, because Keith Thurman was stripped of his WBC title due to inactivity. Manny Pacquiao, he defeated Keith Thurman and got a split decision victory over Keith Thurman to collect the WBA title, in which that was July of 2019. Manny Pacquiao, due to inactivity, was put in champion as recess. And Cuban star, welterweight, world champion, who was the WBC regular champion, Yordanis Ugas, was elevated as super champion. But since Yordanis Ugas has not defended the WBA title, Yordanis Ugas will relinquish that title. And according to reports, Manny Pacquiao will be reinstated as the champion, super champion. So this makes Errol Spence, Manny Pacquiao fight a unification bout, 3 belts on the line. With that said, Errol Spence has an interesting take regarding this Manny Pacquiao fight. As I stated, I did an interview with Manny Pacquiao, and I asked Manny Pacquiao what would be, his keys to success against Errol Spence, seeing as though he's at a size disadvantage and he's at an age disadvantage, okay? Errol Spence, 31 years of age. He is 27 wins, no losses, no draws, 21 wins by way of knockout. He stands at 5'9.5". With a 72-inch arm reach, okay? Manny Pacquiao, on the other hand, is 42 years of age. He has 62 wins, 7 losses, 2 draws, 39 wins by way of knockout. 3 times in his career, himself was knocked out. Stands at 5'5", with a 67-inch arm reach. So, Errol Spence is 11 years younger than Manny Pacquiao. He's 5 inches taller than Manny Pacquiao, and he's a 5-inch arm reach advantage over Manny Pacquiao. And so, Manny Pacquiao, he stated that the key for victory for himself, when I asked him, was speed. He said he's going to use his speed to be victorious over Errol Spence Jr. because he cannot match him in size and strength. So he has to use his advantage, what is going to be the speed advantage for Manny Pacquiao. They're both southpaws, okay? I did an interview with Antonio Tarver, the legend Antonio Tarver, who's going into the Florida Hall of Fame. And Antonio Tarver, who's a southpaw, he broke down why southpaws don't like to face off against other southpaws, because their disadvantage is taken away. So with that said, they're both southpaws. Errol Spence is a southpaw. Manny Pacquiao is a southpaw. So Manny Pacquiao, he told me he's going to use his angles, his foot speed, and his hand speed. He says that when he looked at the fight with Errol Spence in his last fight, when he took on 2-division world champion, superstar boxer Danny Swift Garcia, he just didn't look like himself. Now, we know he unified, that being Errol Spence, the belts September 28th of 2019, when he defeated 2-time welterweight world champion superstar boxer Showtime Sean Porter. And with that said, he became the unified world champion. That was September 28th, just 12 days later. He suffered a horrific car accident October 10th. And he was out of the ring for 14 months. And in his fight, his comeback fight was against Danny Garcia, which was seen as a very risky fight for not knowing how he was going to, be coming back. So he fought Danny Garcia. He dominated Danny Garcia. But Manny Pacquiao, he says that, and he and his team, they said that they see a weakness. They see he's not as fast, he's not as quick as he used to be. They always thought that their quickness would be an advantage, but now they definitely feel like it's an advantage. With that said, Errol Spence, he hadn't been with his strength and conditioning coach, Blu-ray, in his last few fights, okay? But when he was with Lamont, he was with Blu-ray when he fought Lamont Peterson, when he fought Chris Algieri, when he fought Kell Brook. You can see a complete difference in Errol Spence. Not that he looked bad in the other fights, but you can see he was just physically stronger. He was breaking his opponents down and he was getting stoppage victories, okay? With Danny Garcia, and Mikey Garcia and Sean Porter, his skill set was what saw him get the victor. Now, Errol Spence, he responds to Manny Pacquiao saying his speed is going to be the difference. First, he said it was going to be his timing. Now, he says he's back with his fitness and strength and condition coach, and he's planning on stopping Manny Pacquiao and retiring Manny Pacquiao now. And Manny Pacquiao, sending Manny Pacquiao off into the sunset, you know, to become president. Manny Pacquiao is a Senate in his country in the Philippines. He's looking to run for president. This took place on an interview done by Fred Barbershop Conversations, where Errol Spence was on Barbershop Conversations, and he did this interview in which he stated that he's looking to stop Manny Pacquiao now. He's going to send him off in retirement. He's looking to make a statement against Manny Pacquiao, and then he wants to go into what is seen to be the biggest fight in the sport of boxing between himself and undefeated three-division world champion, who is a former junior welterweight undisputed world champion. He's the WBO welterweight world champion, widely considered by many to be the number one pound-for-pound fighter in the world, in Terrence Boyd Crawford. Now, that pound-for-pound status has wavered a little bit since Terrence Crawford made his debut at welterweight, and he hasn't fought or had a high-profile fight against a high-profile fighter. He's even admitting of that. So it wavered. You know, some people feel like four-division world champion Mexican superstar Abasa, who is the unified super middleweight world champion Saul Canelo Alvarez, is the number one pound-for-pound fighter. Some people think Errol Spence is number two, number one. Depends on, you know, who you fancy the most. With that said, skill set, Errol Spence, we know is his skill set is what's going to give Manny Pacquiao tons and tons of problems, because Manny Pacquiao has never done well with high-skill fighters, okay? Especially high-skill fighters that are counterpunchers, that have size and range on him, okay? Manny Pacquiao is very awkward, unorthodox, very fast feet. And he has power, definitely in the left hand, okay? So with that said, you know, Errol Spence, he believes that, you know, in this fight, he's going to look to make a statement, not just use his skill set, not just use his technical skill set and his boxing skill set, but he's looking to make a statement and stop Manny Pacquiao, okay? Manny Pacquiao, we know, was brutally knocked out when he took on his rival and four-division world champion Mexican superstar boxer, Juan Manuel Marquez, okay? That was the last time he was knocked out. And Marquez timed Manny Pacquiao, caught Manny Pacquiao coming in, timed him and hit him with a right hand and brutally knocked Manny Pacquiao out cold. So with that said, you know, Errol Spence, he believes that he wants to make a statement against Manny Pacquiao, and then he wants to go into what at that time would be an undisputed showdown, which is considered the biggest fight in the sport of boxing, between himself and Terrence Bud Crawford. So, you know, I asked Antonio Tarver what would be the biggest, you know, advantage. He says that he wants to see if the old man in Pacquiao still has it. You can never count out Manny Pacquiao. But he favors, you know, Errol Spence because of his size and strength. Keith Thurman, who fought, he fought Manny Pacquiao. And he believes that Errol Spence has a lot of technical prowess. Errol Spence skill set, high ring IQ is going to give Manny Pacquiao a lot of trouble. He says that Keith Thurman gets you on the rope. Errol Spence gets you on the ropes. He likes to place his right foot on your outside where he can hit you with a right hook, and he can also hit you with the left hand, which is his signature punch, but he could change it. It could be a uppercut, it could be a straight left hand, you know, straight left to the body, so he could change, you know, the trajectory on the left hand. So he says Errol Spence in the middle of the ring, in the center of the ring, you know, he can walk you down. He's very technical, you know. So he says that he believes that Manny Pacquiao is going to have a lot of trouble with Errol Spence. Obviously, Keith Thurman has never fought Errol Spence. Errol Spence wanted that fight for quite some time, but Keith Thurman was unwilling to do so. And so I personally believe that Errol Spence is going to beat Manny Pacquiao, but I think that Errol Spence is going to get a unanimous decision victory over Manny Pacquiao. I believe his technical skills, I believe his high ring IQ, the ability to judge distance and range, his jab ultimately, I believe is going to be the difference in this fight for himself against Manny Pacquiao, because Manny Pacquiao has a lot of dog in him. And if you make mistakes just trying to walk Manny Pacquiao down, as he did against Kell Brook, Manny Pacquiao has very, very fast feet. I believe that Manny Pacquiao is the fastest feet of any opponent that Errol Spence has faced. And he has these weird, awkward angles that he uses, and he has power still in the left hand and the right hook, okay? So I believe that his skill set is going to somewhat surprise Errol Spence to just how good Manny Pacquiao is. So I believe that Errol Spence is then going to lean on his technical skills to see him be the victor. I believe that there's going to be times where he does attempt to walk down Manny Pacquiao and look to get the stoppage victory over Manny Pacquiao. And it's very possible, because we saw Manny Pacquiao, he started to wear down in the second half versus Keith Thurman. He started to, show signs of fatigue, and Keith Thurman was landing big, clean punches. Keith Thurman was utilizing, in my opinion, too much unnecessary movement at times, which saw him get dropped in the first round, which saw him get badly hurt in the 10th round. Errol Spence won't have those lapses. So there's a strong possibility that he can high guard and walk down Manny Pacquiao, but I believe the best game plan to be victorious against Manny Pacquiao is going to be to use his technical skill set. Because guys, you normally, now obviously we talk about Manny Pacquiao in his prime, and he's not that anymore, but guys that walk forward and try to walk him down and be aggressive against Manny Pacquiao, those are the guys he had his most success against. It's guys with technical skill set that are able to move around the ring, and they're able to think in the ring and counterpunch Manny Pacquiao and time Manny Pacquiao as Keith Thurman was. Those are the guys that give him the most trouble. But Errol Spence definitely has the ability to walk Manny Pacquiao down and get to stop his victory. If there's anybody that can do that with Manny Pacquiao today's time, it's definitely Errol Spence Jr. So I can't wait to see how this plays out and unfolds August 21st in Las Vegas, Nevada. Let's see how this unfolds and plays out. That's all I got for y'all, man. Make sure you hit the like button. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share the videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
This is Amanda, the Real Deal Serrano, and you're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.